a local man who provided security to emergency crews after Hurricane Katrina, getting ready to head to Haiti to provide security there. Team 4 investigator Paul Van Osdahl live in the newsroom with more on this story. Paul.
Well, Andrew, Isfahan Baylog is going to Haiti to provide security for a United Nations agency that's helping earthquake victims. He was supposed to fly to Port-au-Prince tomorrow, but his mission has been put on hold for at least a week because the military is restricting flights into the airport. This is why security consultant Isfahan Baylog has been hired to go to Haiti. But as much as he's needed, he's having a hard time getting there.
Unfortunately, right now, there's such a logistical nightmare as to having permission with the security force that we do have to assist the United Nations. What's going to happen is the food is not going to get out in a timely fashion like it should. It's going to be sitting in at the airport.
Baylog knows about disaster zones. He was in New Orleans providing security after Hurricane Katrina. This is home video he took with his partners.
All I can say, this situation here is absolutely unbelievable.
He came across a dead body, and this video is now being used by the FBI as part of a civil rights investigation into the actions of local police. But as bad as it was in New Orleans, Baylog knows it will be much worse in Haiti.
If you give somebody an order, you get macheted. I mean, where we gave orders in New Orleans, they complied.
He says the fact that relief agencies even need private security in Haiti should send a strong message.
It tells you it's very dire. I mean, if the U.S. military cannot control it 100%, I mean, it tells you that it's a very bad situation.
Baylog says he expects to be in Haiti for as long as 6 months. I asked him what lesson he took away from New Orleans that might be helpful in Haiti. His answer, patience. Live in the newsroom, Paul Van Osdahl, Channel 4 Action News.